powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
This is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad. You're welcome to pray and prophesy to your day. And today we'll be sharing on something I believe that is very important as we pray and prophesy to our day. The first thing I want us to know this morning is that God has a great plan for your life. A plan to establish you. A plan to empower you. A plan to bring you to a place of prominence, excellence, and greatness. And today we're sharing that you have authority over this situation. You know, it's important we understand that we have authority over any situation before us, whether it's a financial situation, a career situation, a job situation, whatever the situation is in the natural, we have authority over the situation. In Christ Jesus, we are expected to live above circumstances, situations, and the trials of life. We are not expected to be defeated by what defeats others. We are not expected to be conquered by what conquers others. We are not expected to be subdued by the circumstances that subdue others, because we have authority over the situation. You have authority over the situation. Whenever you're dealing with any problem, whether it's an emotional problem, a relationship problem, a career problem, a problem in your job, always have this mentality that I have authority over this problem. In 1 Samuel chapter 17, we saw how David stood before Goliath with boldness. He knew who he was in God. He understood the relationship he has with God, that with that relationship, that Goliath was not going to be a challenge to him. A lot of people look at their situation from the perspective of their limitation, from the perspective of their inability and their lack of resources, but God wants us to look at the situation from the perspective of his will. You see, when you look at the situation from the perspective of the will of God, you have this tendency to rise above it, because your faith in God will become productive and effective to produce the God kind of results in this situation. If our perspective is based on God's word, no matter what the situation is, we're going to win. If our perspective is based on God's word, and this is what makes you successful, this is what makes you win in life, this is what makes you reign in life, when your perspective is based on God's word. God doesn't want you to look at the situation from the perspective of your limitation. He wants you to look at the situation from the perspective of your authority in Christ Jesus. So you need to understand this, that you have authority over the situation. So no matter what it is right now, no matter what the circumstances is right now, you have authority, the authority to speak, the authority to receive that which belongs to you in Christ Jesus, the authority to enforce the will of God over the situation. You have authority to deal with the situation. You know, this situation is not bigger than the God in you. This situation is not greater than the Christ in you. This is why it's important for we to have a progressive revelation of who we are in Christ. It's very important to have a progressive revelation of who we are in Christ, a progressive revelation of what we can do with the Christ in us, a progressive revelation of what we can manifest in Christ Jesus. A progressive revelation is important if we're going to reign in life, if we're going to succeed in life, if we're going to be all that God wants us to be. There is power in Christ Jesus. He said, you will know the truth and the truth will make you free. Either you become free by the word of God. God's word brings the ability to make a difference. So when I read God's word, I receive inspiration, I receive correction, I receive direction. And if I consistently stay in the revelation of who I am in Christ, it will help me exercise authority over the situation. So no matter what the situation is, whether it's a death-threatening situation that has to do with health, that has to do with maybe you got involved in a situation that you don't know what to do, always understand that you have authority over the situation. This is the kind of mentality God expects us to exhort. This is the kind of mentality that exonerates us from fear and unbelief. This is the kind of mentality that empowers us to take the lead in the midst of the situation. So we shouldn't be the type of people, the kind of people that just quit on God because they didn't see the result, but we have authority over the situation. So whatever the situation is right now, remember that you have authority over the situation. In Daniel chapter 6, we saw in Daniel 6 verse 3 that this Daniel was preferred above all because he had an excellent spirit. We saw how Daniel subdued situations in his time. And how did Daniel have his victory? Because Daniel trusted in God. He said, trusting in God is the doorway to supernatural living. When you trust in God, he helps you come out from the situation. When you trust in God, he helps you break forth. So no matter what the challenges may be, if you can trust God, you can come out of the situation. If you can trust God, this is the doorway to success. It's trusting God. It's believing God. It's making his word the foundation for your thinking. It's allowing his word to influence you. In Daniel chapter 3, we saw Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, how the king commandment was given that whoever that does not bow to the king's command or to the image or whatever that the king of that day was trying to do. He wanted to exalt himself above measure. He wanted to make the people worship and bow before him. And a decree was made that whoever that does not bow will be thrown into the fire. But we have Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. These guys were people who understand their covenant position in Jehovah. They understand their covenant position. They also understood their covenant rights in Jehovah. And when the instruction was given, they decided to stay with the word of God. Let me say this to you. No matter what the situation is, always see God as your source. And don't allow the opinion of others to distract you from what you believe about God. Don't allow, someone could say, oh, if you don't bow, you're going to lose the job. If you don't bow to this woman, if you don't bow. And you know that these people are worshiping strange God. They say, if you want to get the job, you must belong to our cult or to our group. And you know their group is not people doing the word of God. Always remember you have authority over the situation. For those three Hebrew boys, they decided to exhort the word of God in the midst of the situation. They decided to exalt the word of God. They decided to believe the word of God. They preferred to be burnt than to bow to the king's command. They preferred to be burnt, and they tie their hands, tie their legs, and threw them into the heat of the fire based on the king's command. But listen to what happened. The scripture said, the heat of the fire slay those who threw them in the heat. That's to let you know how terrible the heat was. If the heat could melt people, could destroy, could melt people, now what will happen to the fire? But there is a supernatural intervention whenever we stand on God's word. There is always a supernatural deliverance when we believe the word of God. You see, the problem is not with what you're going through. The problem may be what you believe, what we believe about the situation. Sometimes the problem is out there saying, oh, I cannot be defeated. It's not possible. You're looking at the situation from the natural. Don't always look at your situation from a natural dimension. Always approach your situation from a supernatural dimension first by having a supernatural mentality. A supernatural mentality, the kind of mentality that tells you, in Christ Jesus, I cannot be defeated. Christ in me, the hope of glory. Greater is he that is in me than what is in the world. This is the kind of mentality that empowers you to rise above the circumstances. Always see yourself having authority over the situation. No matter what is going on right now in your job, in your finances, you know, the areas where we have been given authority, it's so important that we understand the authority we have concerning the spoken word. You know, one of the ways we exercise our authority is by speaking. We exercise our authority. When you are speaking the word of God, you are exercising your authority. You know, in Genesis chapter 1 verse 2, we saw that the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved. Now, in Genesis 1 verse 3, and God said, let there be light. One of the ways God exercises authority over creation is through his word. And the same thing God wants you to do. One of the ways you're going to exercise your authority over the situation is to speak the word of God over the situation. So no matter what the situation is, we can speak the word of God over the situation. No matter what the situation is, we can exercise authority. So right now, no matter what you're going through, whether it's in your job, in your business, maybe there are people trying to have conflict with you in your place of work. They're trying to do all kind of, begin to learn to exercise authority over that situation, because there are spirits using those people. Unknown to us, most situations we approach from a natural dimension, not knowing that they have a spiritual relationship. Sometimes when you see people behave in certain way, there is a spirit responsible for their action. Every human being action is being influenced by a spirit. It's either the Holy Spirit is influencing a person's action, or evil spirit is influencing the person's action. Human beings, we are meant to have relationship with spirits. Yes, you know, because the way we are created is either we are submitting to God, to the Spirit of God, and he flows through us. If we are not careful, we can submit to the enemy. That was what the Bible said, and Satan entered into Judas Iscariot. So the betrayal of Jesus was like a demonic setup, and Satan entered into Judas. So there are people today that demons have entered into them. Satan has entered into them, and they are causing confusion. They are causing crisis. When you see president of a nation or president of any group or organization trying to make problem with his followers or with people, there is a spirit responsible for those activities. You know, sometimes people always address situation from the natural. No, some situation has to be addressed from a spiritual perspective, where you begin to pray in the spirit, begin to bind those spirits that are causing that confusion. You start binding those spirits that are causing the confusion, that are causing the problem. You exercise authority over those spirits by binding those spirits. It's in the name of Jesus, I bind the spirit that is causing this confusion in this office. I cast out the spirit of strife and contention in this place. I cast out the spirit that is causing confusion. You begin to exercise your authority. As long as we don't exercise our authority over the spirit causing the problem, we'll keep being in that state, and the circle will just continue that way. So this is why it is good that you exercise authority over the spirit trying to cause the distraction. Maybe it's in your marriage, maybe it's in your job, and you are having a very good relationship with this person, but suddenly you notice that your attitude is changing. If you don't exercise your authority over that situation may remain that life is spiritual. It takes spiritual knowledge to resolve spiritual problems. I say life is spiritual. It takes spiritual knowledge to resolve spiritual problems. Life is spiritual. It takes spiritual knowledge to resolve spiritual problems. So for we to resolve spiritual problems, we need to have spiritual knowledge. Thank you, Father. You have authority over this situation. Let's begin to pray right now. Rikorobo santara basiketori kababa. Riketolobo shakala basiketori kababa. Riketorobo santara basiketori kababa. Lekamazuka parado seketori kababa. Lekontorobo santara basentorobo. Rikontorobo seketori kababa. Rekotolika barabo sokotolika baba. Rondo robo seketolika baba. Rendo robo seketolika baba. Rindo robo seketolika maraba sotolika baba. Mendere bo seketolika baba seketolika dada. Merika prados ketolika barado seketolika baba. Rindo robo seketolika baba santari baraba. Mredo sontori brades ketolika baba. Mandorobo Sandala Blagada Bredesco Tolika Bradesco Tolibaba. In the name of Jesus, let's begin to bind every spirit that may be contending with whatever you expect to experience in this season. Maybe you're not experiencing it. Let's take authority against every foul spirit. Likaraba Sotoligababa Mandorobo Baba Manderebo Sokotoliglababa. We bind every manipulation. Likandaraba Sokotoli Blagada. We bind every demonic activity going on right now that is not in the Mashondo Robo Sandarababa. We bind every demonic activity right now. In the name of Jesus, we come against every gathering that is not in our favor. In the name of Jesus, Mekolobo Satanedi Kimaruda Sakaparando, Mbredesco to Robo Satarato Seto Robo Satalaba, Leka Mazuka Mazaka Talamba Sotondo Robo Satababa, Mekatalambra Dosco to Rombo Satataranto, Meleketele. In the name of Jesus, we begin to bind every work of darkness. In the name of Jesus, we bind that spirit of confusion. That spirit of confusion, that strife in the office, we cast out the spirit that is causing that contention. Makulida seto robo santara baba, lodo robo secondary kababa. We bind strife and contention in the name of Jesus. Malu sekete repo seto robo santara baba, mele kantara basetonto robo santara baba, rekonto robo santara baba. We bind strife and contention in the name of Jesus. Lakuli kaparanto, mele keto robo santali kapradeste tolika baba, rendo sakatalim. Brodos ketolika baba, rando seketolika parado seketolika baba, ronto sokotolika prades ketolika baba, rindo lo sokotolika pasetolika baba, mandoya pasatolika parando seketolika baba, nolika prados ketorobo sototolika pasetetolika baba, meleka parando sokotolampa shakatalampa, malika telempo setetelimpa rapasantolika baba rando, merindo robo santa rabasento robo. Redeske to rombo senton to robo santa la baba ricambra deske to li cambra da sento li baba mando lobo sokundo li blagada ma santa li blagada ricambra da sakanda li blagada ma santo li blagada mandere debo sento li blagada ma santo li blagada ringra ba sokundo li blagada ma santo li blagada. Thank you Holy Ghost, thank you Lamb of God. Mandolobo Santala Blagada Randorobo Sakababa will begin to speak to everything that represents a mountain, every mountain in the name of Jesus. Rakaraba Sotoligababa Likama Sakatalikabaraba Sekotoligababa Likondorobo Sekondoli Labababa Mandelebo Santala Babababa Likama Sokotolikabababa Likamaraba Sokondoli Blagadama Sontoli Labababa Likandalikababa Sakondali Blagadama Sokondole blagada, rundo robo sandala blagada, masuntoli blagada baba, mandolo baba 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 baba, nundele blagada baba baba baba, randere bo sandole blagada, rusa tararara basutara baba, rusa tararara basutara baba baba, rusa tarababa baba baba, rusa tarababa baba, Holy Ghost mandali blagada baba baba, Holy Ghost mayakatali blagada gada, rinke delele bondoli blagada baba baba, rikambra disekundoli blagada gada, masuntoli blagada. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy that today is going to be a stress-free day for you. That you will step into greater favor. You will step into greater opportunity. In the name of Jesus, every need is met. Every bill is paid. In the mighty name of Jesus, I decree and I declare that your heart desire will be granted in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will supernaturally open doors for you today. Mandu Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lamb of God. Thank you, Ashadai. Thank you, Jehovah Jireh. Thank you, I am that I am. Thank you, Jehovah Nissi. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we give you worship. Lord, we give you adoration. Makula leseko lobo satalika parato seketolika baba. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lamb of God. Thank you, El Shaddai. Masuto lobo satarababa. Rakanda rabasuto lobo satarababa. Likde leke makuro lobo satanderibo. Rikanda rabasunto lobo satarababa. Rikapa pradese tolika. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Miracles are taking place right now. Miracles are taking place right now. Miracles of divine opportunity. Miracles of divine open door. Miracles of preferential treatment. Opportunities are coming your way. Opportunities are happening around you right now. Mundo robo sandala ba 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 ba. Masokoto lobo satala ba ba ba. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Makuri kaparando seketolika bababa. Reketolika pradosketolim bradesketolim baba. Malaka radoseketolika pradesketolika baba. All things are possible. All things are possible. It doesn't matter where you are right now. There is a miracle with your name on it. All things are possible. Healing is possible. Be healed in your body. Be healed in your spirit. I rebuke that spirit of depression. It's on one. You're watching me. You've been battling with depression. I rebuke that spirit of depression right now. In the name of Jesus, I decree that depression to be gone by the power of God. You're free. Makula take it to Baba Rakondo Robo Sakala Basete Tetere Brodeske Tolika Baba Rando Seke Tolika Pradeske Tolika Baba Randia Kamalukanda Rabasoto Lobo Melekanda Rabosoko Tolika Parabosoto Libaba. In the name of Jesus, receive preferential treatment, receive supernatural increase. Your needs are met, your bills are paid. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Lamb of God. Thank you, El Shaddai. Likundo robo sakara baseto tori baba baba. Rikete liba seto robo sakala baba. Riko robo satara baseto riga baba. Rikete libo seketo lika baba baba baba. Rikonto labla kadara baseto lika baba baba. Rikoto lika parade seketo lika baba baba. Rikanda laba seketo lika bara baseto tori baba. Rikoto lobo sakata laba seketo lika baba baba. Mato robo seketo lika basakata. We bind every form of sudden death in the name of Jesus. We take authority over every form of sudden death in the name of Jesus. We rebuke that sudden death in the name of Jesus. We speak peace right now. I speak healing right now. I speak deliverance right now to people watching all over the world. Receive your healing. Receive your deliverance. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Today is going to be a stress-free day for you. Today is going to be a day of preferential treatment. Supernatural open doors, miracles of opportunity, miracles of greater things in the name of Jesus. Likandaraba seketoli baba, reketoli kaprade seketori kababa, rekotolobo sakatali kabaraba, ritorobo setondorobo santarababa, rekandari bragadama sokondorobo setondori bragada. In the name of Jesus, likoma alain seketoli baba. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus, if you're watching this broadcast right now and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and your Savior, the greatest thing you could ever do with your life is to hand it over to God and let Him do something with it. Let Him do something great with your life. If you're watching this broadcast right now and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God have raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray that prayer with us, it means you're born again, and the Spirit of God is going to lead you from this day forward. Now, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. On YouTube is Faithman Teaching on YouTube, and these are messages and teachings that will change your thinking and empower you to take the lead in the direction of the will of God. So I encourage you to subscribe to Faithman Teaching on YouTube, and you will never remain the same. And also want to encourage you to keep watching finishworktv.com. It is my joy to help more people receive God's word, because I know that every problem can be resolved by the integrity of God's word. So I'd like you to watch finishworktv.com. It's a place of inspiration, a place of wisdom, a place to receive understanding. Finishworktv.com. And also we'll encourage you with our viewers to consider partnering with this ministry. You know, it's so important that we know that partnership is very strategic in preaching the gospel. Jesus said, was sharing something, he said, except you abide in me, you know, you can do nothing. He said, without me, you can do nothing. You see, he strengthens us to partner with one another to be able to move the gospel forward and change the lives of people. So you can partner with us today on PayPal, is faithmanteaching@gmail.com. Thank you so much for watching this broadcast. And also you can reach out to me on Facebook. On Facebook is Faithman Ogboada of Faithman Ogboada Ministry. Thank you for viewing this broadcast. Until my next broadcast, don't ever forget this. There is greatness in you.